So Project Power is a unique idea, I think, for a superhero film about people with superpowers. It has a really interesting premise that I think you could do quite a bit with. So the whole idea is that it takes place in the near future, where the only like huge technological advancement has been that on apparently the black market, they've developed these special pills that grant you like superpowers, but they only grant them for about 5 minutes. You ingest them and then they give you like a special power. It's kind of interesting though, like because it seems like sometimes you can't tell what kind of power you get. Like sometimes you might get like freeze ability, or you might turn into fire, you might be invisible, or your head could literally explode. So it's kind of like a gamble, you know, every time you take a pill. And it seems like apparently you can overdose on these pills as well. So you have this really interesting kind of like treating superpowers as drugs, which is it's kind of I like this idea. I think there's a lot of fun stuff you can do with it. Obviously, like it puts a lot of limits on the powers, which I think are really interesting. So you have to use them sparingly, and they're like a risk to your body. So there's a lot of cool stuff you can do with that. The problem I think with Project Power is that it's kind of all over the place trying to find something to do with this premise. So it takes place in New Orleans, and we essentially follow three characters whose lives intersect while they're trying to track down the people who are dealing in these pills. So the main character, I think, who we follow the most, who has the most complete arc here, is the Major, who's played by Jamie Foxx. In a very kind of like interesting role, I think, for him. Here's a role where he has like some pathos. He's supposed to be ruthless. He breaks the rules. He tries to go undercover. He's reluctant to work with people. So it's an interesting character. I think Fox does the most with what he can with it. I think like Jamie Foxx works really well as kind of like an anti-hero. So this seems very much in his league for the type of film he could do. Like I think at one point they've mentioned he's trying to get into playing the character of Spawn, which I think is a good choice. Like he does well as like kind of either villains or anti-heroes. He just has like this great menace to him, and he slips pretty easily into this role here. I think it works really well for him. The other character we follow is a cop, Frank Shaver, who's played by Joseph Gordon-Levitt. And he's basically tracking down, you know, who's selling these pills and who to bring in, but also taking the pills himself. So he's kind of like a, you know, he's kind of like a little bit of like a Dirty Harry cop here who kind of like breaks the rules to try to like bring in these criminals who are using these, you know, powers to manipulate their bodies. He's basically fighting fire with fire. And then we have the young teenager character of Robin, played by Dominique Fishback. And she deals in the drugs, but she also apparently like her whole deal is like she's an excellent rapper, but she doesn't really have faith in those abilities. Kind of an interesting parallel here of like, you know, your natural abilities versus, you know, the superpowers that you would ingest. And I don't know, when they first introduced her like that, I kind of thought, well, you know, there could be a unique parallel there between, you know, embracing your own abilities and you know, being conflicted about taking these artificial ones. But the film never quite gets to that point, mainly because like it separates these three characters out and they only kind of come together in the third act. I mean, in the second act, Robin and the Major do connect, and they have some decent chemistry. Not a lot, but they connect well enough. I like the fact that Major has a, you know, he has like a real drive in this film, I think more than any other character, because he's looking for his daughter, who apparently possesses the more natural superpowers, like superpowers that can last more than 5 minutes. So he's basically tracking her down, and of course, you know, there's some evil, you know, conglomerate syndicate that is, of course, holding her hostage. And so eventually, by the third act, they will all team up together to stop these guys. And it's kind of, you know, it's very much similar to Netflix's other kind of superhero film of the Old Guard from a few weeks back, in that you have this interesting premise, and there's some interesting ideas kind of explored here. Like I like the whole, you know, the whole kind of like street premise of like superpowers being a drug that you deal in, and it feels, excuse me, and it feels like there are interesting aspects that are touched upon here and there, but they're kind of just mostly just kind of like shoved to the back for this very, very, very simple story of just the major trying to get back his daughter. So it's basically just like a rescue mission, and eventually it turns into, stopping the syndicate dealing in these power drugs. That being said, for being, for essentially just evolving into a little more than action, the action scenes are not too bad here. They're actually pretty competently assembled. In particular, I love the scene where the major infiltrates a group of like rich people trying to show off these powers, and how one of them goes awry with this one woman in a tank who uses this freeze ability that is essentially slowly killing her. And we're in the tank with her, and we're looking from the inside on the outside of what the major's doing on the outside of the tank, which is basically gunning down everyone outside. So there's this, I really like the way this scene is shot, because it goes between the woman freezing, and then we look out the window and we can see like Jamie Foxx, kind of, fighting off these bad guys. Then we cut back to the woman slowly dying, and we cut back and forth. Interesting parallel though. Parallel there. I really liked one of the earlier scenes where the major is tracking down someone who's dealing in the drugs, and one of them takes the one that essentially turns you into the Human Torch. And basically, Jamie Foxx has to get like really creative about how he's got to escape and also interrogate this guy at the same time when he's made of fire. And I also loved how they showcase how you can OD in that scene here. So there's great. I feel like there's good world building here, and there's a lot of interesting stuff that kept me engaged. It's just when it gets to the third act and it just kind of like settles for these decently shot action scenes, but ultimately kind of hollow in their greater context. Because by this point, we're pretty much just rooting for the Major and Frank and Robin to save the day, and of course they will, without a whole lot of expected tragedy, because it's like th this film, like it's established kind of like fairly dark, pretty damn violent, but also fairly quirky. Like we get to know just enough about like the Major and Frank and Robin, to like them enough with their banter. I don't feel like we get to understand a lot about Frank or Robin. Like we understand enough about their backstories and their drive. But I don't feel like we get the whole picture of them. It feels like we get more of the major, and it kind of stresses that point. Well, if the major is the most interesting character, then why not make the whole film about him and just kind of have these other characters as like su as more smaller supporting roles? Because it becomes clear pretty early on that that Frank and Robin are just supporting characters for the major's arc here. That being said, I did like the scene where Frank tracks down a guy who's invisible, and Frank himself takes the pill that makes him impervious to bullets. So I kind of like how that's staged there. It's got some neat slow motion, some interesting effects here and there. So yeah, like it's a very competently shot film, but I feel like it kind of loses that world-building appeal and kind of runs out of ideas by the third act and just kind of like settles for the action we kind of expect from this type of film. So it's only kind of like a mild disappointment. It's a mild disappointment in that it's got great ideas and it explores a little bit of them, but not a whole lot. I feel like there's so much more that you could do with this film that I would honestly be up for a sequel if it wanted to be like more of an anthology, because it seems like this is the type of story that would be perfect for an anthology where you follow like a troubled teen, a cop who doesn't play by the rules, an undercover gangster. There's all these different aspects I feel that are really cool that I feel you could explore here, if you opened it up and didn't contain it to this box of just like a search and rescue mission, which I feel kind of holds the film back. It's not that you couldn't do that well. In truth, I actually kind of like how the Major kind of has like this PTSD where he dips in and out of reality when trying to remember his daughter. That was a nice touch as well. That's kind of my whole feeling on the film. It's got like these nice little touches here and there, and there was always something that kept drawing me back in, but then kept forcing me back out, with the action scenes that were nice. I like the way they were assembled. But don't really evoke the full potential of these, of having superpowers within a pill. I feel like there's a lot you could do with this material, and it feels like it's only kind of just scraping the surface here. So, for Project Power, 2.5 out of 5 stars.